Good morning, happy Friday. I was just getting ready to use my Luxury Confidence Blackhead Remover for the second time this week and thought I would give you a little more information about this. This tool comes with four different tips. I have the tip for the face on right now. Comes with four different tips, a USB charging cord, and your money back guarantee. Get a full refund up to 90 days if you're not satisfied with the product. This product helps keep your pores clear and clean, makes your face feel so much smoother, and helps with the texture. I just finished using it on my entire face. I switched from this end, which does the face, and then this one does the nose. Even though I did this the other day, there is lots of gunk in there. If you don't want to see, look away. Yeah. Don't forget to use Nest 100 at checkout to save $100. That offer ends Sunday at midnight. Taking Buck for a walk and I heard a big pop. I don't know if there was a wreck or if the transformer blew, so I'm in the dark. And I really need to style. I wanted to give you an update on the table that I used Stripwell on yesterday. I never explained how you use it. You spray a very light coat on for 15 and let it sit for 15 minutes. You go back and spray another coat, a little thicker coat, and then you can do a third and fourth time. And I was just taking one of these little putty knives and just scraping to see how much gunk I could get off. Let me show you the difference. The table looks like now. I'm gonna put a picture on here also so you can see what it looked like yesterday. I am going to sand this now because most of the polyurethane came off. Same thing with down there. I'm just gonna sand it, restain it, and it should be good to go. Oh, and the joints, they're way better today. We're back out in the garage and we got the rest. Let me back that up. We left off after just taking the notch out of the top. We got it out of the bottom too. We are now laying out the legs. Whoa. That was
whoa.
That was quite noisy. We're now laying out the legs, and then we cut. Rob said we could have bought 93-inch 2x4s, but we bought 96 and trimmed them down 3 inches. So basically, we're making what is he called this? Like a
just the frame.
The frame. That's right. I wanted to call it a pattern, but don't ask me why. But we're making the frame of the one side. Finished with one side of the workbench. So this side, this is going up against the wall. Is that correct?
This side's going to be what you see. No, this side on this over here is going to, this is the inside.
Oh, okay.
So this side on this side will be the outside.
Okay. Rob knows what's going on. I don't. Completed both frames. We took the notched out 4x4s and added the 2x4s to them. So this is the top of the frame. That will be a shelf. So we laid it down. And now since this is the inside, we're adding a 2x2 on top of the 2x4 because there will be a shelf right here going this way. I've always wanted to do the things that we're doing right now. I know that might sound odd coming from a female, but I've always wanted to do this. I've always wanted to use a pocket hole maker.
Folks, here's what I want to say.
I've always wanted to notch out pieces in a 4x4.
And I live to just make dreams come true like this.